she made, and how did she season them? With ham, salt, yeah, and it was, and it actually had like a soup.
Were that the white, were they the white ones?
Yeah.
I've had them, they're not bad.
I love all kinds of lima beans. I love Brussels sprouts, broccoli, I love all that. Turnips, I love turnips.
I do like turnips.
Carrots, I like carrots.
You know, you can pickle turnips, yeah. You slice them thin, slice them to matchstick, like long slivers, and then just put them in a vinegar base.
And I like parsnips, like all that stuff. What I do not like are beets. I just don't like beets.
See, I can eat it.
She cooks, my grandmother loved them.
Did you do pickled beets?
What, they pickled beets?
She had pickled beets.
Yeah, they.
Pickled or.
I can eat them, I don't love them, but I'll take them over a lot of other vegetables.
I don't like them with butter, I just like them pickled.
She cooks them both ways, but I mean, I just don't like them. And she used to eat this horseradish, and I'd have to leave the table, it made me so sick. Fresh horseradish.
I know you like, Mother, you like the pickled pig's feet.
Oh, wow.
Have you had that?
Pig's feet?
No, me either.
You like them, Johnny?
It's okay. That's how my brother weighed too, when I picked it up.
You like pickled pig's feet, don't you, Susie?
Yes, I do.
I like pig's feet with corn off the bone with hot sauce on it.
No, I don't like that.
Oh, that's good.
Johnny likes anchovy.
Yeah, you know I don't like that.
Do you?
No, no, he's got to tell the story.
I ain't telling no story.
All right, I'll tell the story for him.
I figured you would.
I went. He knows I do like exotic things because obviously exotic means that you haven't tried it. So you want to try it, and then you can, if you don't like it, you just exit off the list of things that you don't want. But until you try it, you don't know. So I heard out anchovies, and I thought that must be some wonderful spice. And I like spices, like hot stuff.
I love it.
Yeah, that's what I thought it was, a spice. So we ordered a little thing over there at the Harvest Inn, the drive-in. And the woman, they brought it back, and I took a bite, and the first thing I said was, this tastes like little dead fish. You know what I mean? And that's what it turns out it is. It's little dead fish. Anchovies is little dead fish.
They're fish.
Only after they kill.
And very salty.
They look, they're salty, and I swear I saw hair on them, but they have little hair things on them.
I never saw that.
Really big.
That was their spine.
I ordered a pizza one time for the kids at Pizza Hut, I'll never forget. And I said, no anchovies, they all pepperoni and mushrooms is all they would eat. And they gave me this pizza with a bunch of stuff on it. They were all these little hairy things that come. I said, took it home, threw it around, came back. I said, we can't eat the pizza. They said, you want another one? I said, no. I don't.
Tell
we just lost our appetite.
I can't eat anchovies because of the gout. I can't eat that. And I love it.
You love it?
Love it.
Tell her what you did with the kids and saw it goes across it.
Oh, Crosby. We get gifts from Santa Claus, Mr. and Mrs. Claus.
Excuse me, Crosby. What'd you say?
Can I have some of your sauerkraut?
Yes, but I brought it here.
Well, I know, but you and Dad can eat it because I was
I have saved some. I have.
Well, did you?
Oh, okay. To send Johnny some.
No, on the, no, to gift cards on the present.
But it was a little note.
Look, it just said from, you know, the little to and from? From Mr. and Mrs. Santa Claus, Frosty and family. Yeah, we even had names for the kids, the Frosty kids.
Oh, I thought they wrote little notes,
and,
too.
And Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
Oh, I thought Santa wrote the notes.
And all the other reindeer, they got these little, so they were so excited when they got their little things.
One of the things you,
yeah.
As a child, you always loved.
Well, they did. They loved that. They used to always have their little games, you know. And they'd go, oh, this one's from Frosty and Mrs. Santa Claus. And I think, I forgot the names of the kids that we made up. Jilly and Spuddy and Rudolph and Reindeer and the Elves. And I would have a Santa Claus. You know, with Mr. and Mrs. Claus on, and have a reindeer with Rudolph on it.
You're a big girl. What
Where is Zippy, did Danny?
Zippy is at home.
All is well.
They're making, she's cooking dinner. She got everything from mom.
Mom and dad get the meal.
Oh, good.
In some way, shape, or form.
Yes, I get some, they get some.
She already passed on, done everything, she wants to go back.
Except for that, she said she already saved some sauerkraut, so I don't know.
She loves them, passed on, loves them. We gotta go steal some chickens. Okay, no, I'm serious, I'm game, let's go.
We gotta steal some raw milk.
You gonna get a rest?
They don't have raw milk next door.
No, it's abandoned, they're free chickens.
How come?
They're running gone, by the way.
Somebody has to own that property.
Well, if they're running loose, they don't know.
They have abandoned those chickens.
They made it up with a chicken, oh, nothing here.
Yeah, must've got loose or something.
They have abandoned the chickens, there doesn't seem to be anybody that lives in the house anymore, and the chickens are there. And they look very fat and healthy, I mean, there's nothing wrong with them, they're fine doing what they're doing.
Lucky too, with all the fox around.
Well, that's what I said to Shannon, I said, I can't believe it without guarding, you know, the parents.
That something wouldn't have got.
I don't know.
No, you said, you know, we're good at this.
No, you can't do everything by yourself, my goodness.
She won't let me help, she won't let me help, I tried, that I'm not gonna help, but they say, no, get out of the way.
Well, we could take, you wanna take this in, Johnny, to, oh, has to come back.
Put that under my coat.
And the gravy?
Got it.
You already got it.
No, dinner has to settle before you.
Andy has a hot spot, two of them.
Really?
So that's fleas, right?
Not necessarily.
That one on her ear.
Could be just some fungus, you know, they scratch and then it gets fungus in it. You know what helps on hot spots is bag balm. You know bag balm, right?
Well, you get it in the.
I get it, you get it at the feed store, you get it at, where did I get mine? Target, I got mine at Target.
What is it, salve?
Yes, I would hit it down.
It's what you put on the udders of cows.
Fungus.
But where'd it come from, if it's not a flea?
It could be from just her scratching, it itches and she's continually itching.
Could be allergy, right?
Well, fungus causes you to itch.
Allergy.
Could be an allergy, she's getting older, usually it's fungus.
I'm sure she said she was.
Cause fungus itches, you know, just keeps itching, so you keep scratching. But bag balm's pretty good stuff, I use that on Sophie and she stops scratching.
Yeah, we took Pepper for a walk and we gave her a bone that she wanted, so that'll keep the skin base on.
I'm gonna take my insulin down.
Test your insulin.
Yeah, we're gonna try that stuff out, it's gonna suffer a little bit, and that could be a panacea. We would take that, that will stop scratching, I'll be so happy, she'll be happy as Christmas.
Can we get it to birthday store or do you have to get it from?
I'm not sure, I'll probably pass it away. You can look at the bag is right, let me take a picture of it. You get a bigger bag, we'll probably get it for $1 or $10.
Write the name down.
I'm taking a picture of the bag.
Slip the dressing in half, your mom and dad half, and Patty and John.
Oh, we don't wanna take your dressing. You need leftovers.
If they wanna give us dressing, let, take the dressing. People offer you something, they wanna give it to you, you should take it. I'll bite your finger off.
The rod is not.
You're not wearing any jeans.
Watch me, that nene got you in a lot.
I didn't do nene, I said, what did I say?
Yeah.
I forgot, oh, okay, whatever.
Just had jeans for the next 6 months.
You're not wearing jeans.
Watch me!
You're not, oh, no, I'll do it every day.
Get down on your knees and apologize.
I'm not kidding nobody.
All right, then it's not gonna happen.
I know something else, I'm not gonna have honeybee.
All right.
Honeybee.
Beyonce.
No. I know what you're talking about, I'm not paying attention.
Do you have this much trouble with him? Not listening?
You know what?
Huh?
I always listen to my father, he'll tell you.
Susie, did he always listen as a child?
I'm sorry, say again?
Did you have problems with him listening as a child?
Oh.
Listen to this.
Yeah. Kidding me? I've got a nightmare.
I have a hard time getting her to listen.
Oh, really?
Yes. gum chewing thing, you?
Guy, let me give you a bit of advice.
Yes, listen to Shannon, he's wise.
Not necessarily.
I'm gonna give you a quiz.
Uh-oh.
It's a Will Rogers quiz.
Oh, that's Will Rogers.
There are two ways to have an argument with a woman.
Oh, really?
He goes, uh-oh.
Really?
Yes.
Uh-oh, you're gonna store her up.
Neither one works, so forget it.
There you go.
We love it.
There you go.
But you know, why is it that you can't train a man?
What? We don't train men. They're not dogs. You know what? That's much worse than what I did. Using the term train a man.
No, I'm serious. Go ahead and say it. I'm listening.
No, that's much worse.
Watch me.
Well, I'm glad you wore a dress. Did I say how pretty it looked? I did. Yes, darling. And your hair, I said, oh, now you gotta do it to me. And what, you know what else? I told you how pretty your hair was too, didn't I?
She's not listening for you, Lil.
Oh, come here, Lil.
Well, she went over to mother.
Lily, pretty girl. She's a pretty girl. And come here. Oh, she's a pretty girl.
We ran out of pickled possum paws. You gotta get some more pickled possum paws for next year.
We like them. We're just about out.
Where did you get your wood for your, where you're hanging your baskets? Your barn wood, isn't it?
It's an old barn timber. We traded a guy a wood stove for it maybe 30 years ago.
Wow.
Not just for this piece, for a lot of this.
No, for that piece.
Just for that piece? You traded him a wood stove for that piece?
Yes.
Not for that piece.
Because you can't find that.
Well, they were expensive then. Now, somebody...
They're outrageous.
I'm a little surprised that that's expensive.
It is.
Somebody recently told me if you want something like that, it'd be about $1,000.
Yeah, really?
You gotta be kidding.
If that.
No.
If you can get it.
Right.
You'd have to go to West Virginia, I think, or Pennsylvania to get that.
I don't think you get it now, because everybody has ads in papers where they buy old farm wood. And what happens is we're close to Lancaster here.
Oh.
So everything within a 100-mile radius has been bought because they make furniture out of the old wood.
Yeah, they do.
Really? Yes.
That's nice. I love it.
Well, we have that thing that holds a television. That was $400. That was old barn wood.
Oh, yeah. Was it?
Wow. They just polished it up.
What year was that house built on Ridge Road, you know?
Were you all the second owners?
Probably third.
No. We're the fourth.
Mm-hmm.
I told you all about the ghost?
Yeah.
I did? Yeah, we don't have
Why do you make time to go down the hallway once you have to go on in?
No, the ghost is up the street. We didn't get a ghost. We were hoping. The computer went on by itself a couple times lately. We thought that was a ghost.
We're in bed. We're like, what is that? What is that?
And we're pretty sure it's not a ghost.
I'm not
totally sure. We figured a ghost don't know that much about computers.
It couldn't be a mouse. She's got too many dogs and a cat.
We better not have a mouse.
He would go
after anything. He loves anything that moves. Plastic bags. He goes crazy.
That's from living on the street. He wants to eat constant.
He wants you to put food down all the time.
But yeah, from living on the street, he's going after plastic.
In the kitchen. You know where you're sitting this morning?
He did lose a little weight, so he's starting to eat.
You're sitting on top of the dog food cans. Beside the fridge.
Trying to send a message.
He's a great cat, though.
This dog here can hunt up your
That's a nice dog.
Dog food.
Really?
Yeah.
That's a nice dog.
Got a good nose.
Really? Wow.
Did you pat her on
She's killed how many? 20-some
What, herbs?
Groundhogs.
No.
Wow, I'm surprised.
Killed them?
Killed them.
I'm surprised they didn't get the best of them.
My cousin's dog, they had to put to sleep because of that.
Then on its leg, it was
a terrier.
Yeah.
It was a pretty big dog, not that big, I think. They were a pretty big dog, 35 pounds. And it bit the dog, and they took it to the vet.
She has that sincerity.
We cleaned it all up, gave him a shot, and it got so infected, it just wouldn't heal. And then they were gonna cut the leg off, but they had to put the dog to sleep because it just got so bad.
That's horrible.
Groundhog. My dog was 35 pounds, a coon dog. He got into a fight with this 30-pound, huge, what do you call it, raccoon. Huge. And it tore his lip up and bit him off. But they got him. It's like, oh.
How many have groundhogs have really get?
19, 20, something like that.
She's in her 20s now. She really is.
I'm surprised that they don't hurt her.
She, we had two labs. We had another lab before her bear. And labs, when they attack a groundhog, are different than any other dogs attack.
Oh.
Most dogs, including hound dogs,
yeah.
They'll get around.